young black king.
Hey, what's going on, cuz?
Young man, I am not your cuz. Hey, yo! I'm one of the descendants of the true chosen people. Do you know this, my brother?
Damn. Oh, God bless you, bro.
Why God do you serve? The true and living Yeshua? Or do you better not take off. I will knock you through that windshield.
Come over here, man. What's your name, man? What's your name, brother?
Lee.
Lee, that's a strong name, man. Where you from?
I'm from Atlanta, man.
From Atlanta, that's a good black city right there. What's your nationality?
Shit, I mean, shit. Black?
Lost ass nigga, man. Oh, you see, man, what I'm saying? Yo, get these niggas is lost out here.
That's right.
Give me Ezekiel 45.
Ezekiel 45.
Give me Ezekiel.
That's right.
Get that goddamn poison out your mouth.
That's
man.
Right.
That's what's wrong with the black man. Putting that goddamn poison in your body.
That's,
man.
That's right.
That's what's wrong with you, man. We talking about the word. That's what's wrong with you, niggas.
Got his head covered,
man.
Too,
and take this goddamn madness off your head.
Got his head covered.
We talking about the word, man. Lost that
word.
Command.
His head covered.
That's right. Listen up, man. Don't ever take your eyes off the Most High, man.
That's right.
The Most High is going to kill your ass. You know what? Read the scripture, man. Shut the fuck up and read the scripture at the same time. Read it. Shut the fuck up. Read it.
That's right.
7:45, man.
Lawmakers led a march to the state capitol. People held signs and chanted. Reverend Al Sharpton spoke to crowds criticizing the DeSantis administration for attacking black culture.
Was a housing project that was under construction, intended to provide low-cost housing to older people and really to regenerate this part of the city that had been neglected for many years.
Watching the flames, heartbroken, the pastor whose church raised the money for the project.
Somebody who did this did not understand his message. Somebody who did this doesn't know that for 8 years I've been working hard to bless this community. And while I was across town organizing pastors who largely didn't understand why we should hit the streets, I'm organizing them for peace in the community. And somebody's over here burning down what they don't even understand.
Peace. Y'all gotta give us that. If y'all keep coming and taking everything we got, we gotta take what y'all got. We're not playing out here. This is not a war, but we want our rights.
I want to give all the praises and the honor to Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shah Bahashem, Recha Ha Kodash, and double honors to the elder apostles and bishops of Great Millstone. Honors as well to you, brethren, you other elders, you few sisters, you followers of the faith. All you who make up the body of this ministry, shalom to the elect. So anyway, this video, actually I wanted to do this a couple days ago, but I'm just now getting to doing it. It's titled, it's a response off the elder of South Carolina, GMS South Carolina, Elder Manat Dezatbah. It says, black people mocking Hebrew Israelites is prophecy. And I got halfway through the video, almost to the end, and then immediately, because I got edified out of it, and I said, well, you know, he made a couple of points, and then, you know, I said, I'll do this video. And one scripture he brought out was 2 Chronicles, which we'll get that in a second. But, you know, you Jakes, you're just going to have to keep marching, you know, keep marching on, you know, because that's all you're going to do. See, the Lord will mock when your fear cometh. You know, you reap what you sow. Now, these people have such an issue. It almost like, you know, this is a comedic script, but it's almost like you Jakes need that. It's almost like you need to be yoked up, right? You need to be yoked up. That's why I laughed at it a little bit, because this is serious business. You know, the Lord has got to put you out of your miseries. You need to be grabbed, yoked up, you know, and put back in order. But see, you know, the Heavenly Father is going to do that. And a lot of you just got to be put down in order to become back the right way. And then you're going to look at yourself. See, all the destruction that's going on in the so-called black community. When you go to commune, it means an agreeance. These black people ain't under any kind of an agreeance of any kind of community. Right? This guy has the nerve to wear a beard, which shows you it don't make you righteous just because you wear a beard. Now, all the wickedness that black people are doing, will this truth save your life? Yes, it will. You go into dietary laws, you know. You stop being evil towards your brother. My question is, where's their solution? What's your solution? What are we going to do? What are you supposed to do? Because according to the black churches and the black community, the black conscience, the black Africans, the black Egyptians, you ain't done a damn thing but stay black. Let's go to 2 Chronicles 36:16, which the elder brought out, when it says, but they mocked the messengers of Yahweh until there was no remedy. I'm going into a little commentary. I don't know which one I read, but it says, but they mocked the messengers of Yahweh and misused his prophets, imprisoning and persecuting them as they did Jeremiah, or seduced themselves by his prophets. That is, by the prophecies of prophets, which they perverted and misconstrued, an imminent instance of which we have in this, that because Jeremiah prophesied that Zedekiah should be led into Babylon, right? So this is even going to other Israelites who come against us. And we talk about the mark and various other things. But these other black leaders, they're a form of prophets. You know, Black Lives Matter, you know, which is set up by white people. But Al Sharpton, which they all set up by them, you know, about fixing the black communities. You know, this is what ISUPK is on. They're about fixing the black communities. Right? Let me see if I can get another one. Imprisoning and persecuting them as they did Jeremiah, or seduced themselves by the prophets, by their prophecies which they perverted or misconstrued. All you people are led astray, especially you two-thirds, you that's not even in the truth. Some of you in the truth, but some of you that's not in the truth, you are led astray, right, by these false prophets. Proverbs 1:22. How long, ye simple ones, will ye love simplicity? And scorn is delight in their scorning, and fools hate knowledge. Turn you at my reproof. Behold, I will pour out my spirit unto you. I will make known my words unto you, because I have called, and ye have refused. I have stretched out my hand, and no man regarded. But ye have set a knot at all my counsel, and would none of my reproof. You're not listening. Right now you're just making parodies and jokes. I also will laugh at your calamity. I will mock when your fear cometh. Now these jokes and these skits are made by some of you, you know, you Israelites that are forceful, so to speak, in the screaming and yelling. Okay, and that's just the thing that they do, you know, causing, you know, a lot of extra drama on the hedges for more views. We've seen that too. Now, this is like an old school thing, old One West thing, you know, because it did bring the attention. But we don't need all that now, man. All we need is the power of the Lord for you to get it. These are more serious times, so we don't need to do all that. You know, you people, you love wickedness. Jeremiah 4:22, for my people are foolish, they have not known me. They are sottish, means drunkard. They are sottish children, and they have none understanding. They are wise to do evil, but to do good they have no knowledge. These guys will sit up here and make these parodies and jokes and evilness and wickedness. Meanwhile, the BLM that was set up by George Soros, who set three so-called black women, not even a man, set them up, right, with alternative lifestyles and funded them to push your Black Lives Matter when the men was getting blown away. And then you have the mothers who are running these so-called households who allow these young men to behave like them, knowing they're not going to be treated the same way as a mother would. That's why they get blown away. The mother can argue back with the cop. The mother could say, hey, I'm not doing this, because the Queen of Heaven always gives them a break. But not you, Jakes. Not you, Jakes. That's another video I think I'm going to get into. The simp Jakes who allows, you know, this sick behavior by Eve, right? And they honor that. This is why the community's so messed up, man. Christianity is partial to blame. All these guys are probably Christians, believe in Jesus, but we're waking up and they have an issue with it because they want to continue down the road of wickedness, right? They want to continue down their road of wickedness. But anyway, this is one of those videos I don't have much to say on. You know, go check out the video Elder Manat Dazatba did. Let me go back to it again. Black people mocking Hebrew Israelites is prophecy, right? And that's part of it. It definitely is the prophecies. This is why maybe a decade ago I would have saw this and been like really angry. But now I could laugh at these guys, because they're going to reap what they sow. A lot of these guys, a lot of these Jakes and these Eves, they need to really be put out of their misery. The Lord, Proverbs 16 says, the Lord made all things for himself, even the wicked, for the day of evil. You can't have the elect without a non-elect. An elect have to come out of a body of a non-elect. You can't have a non-elect, which is elected on the left-hand side, from the actual elect. So this is definitely prophecy. All the wickedness that goes on in the so-called black community, they have no time on their hands but to come up here and make videos like this just to get a fan base. But this is what they do, just to get some recognition, because people who don't like what we teach, they're going to all follow it anyway, even the Christians. But the joke is on you. You're the one followed white Jesus. You're the one continuing to follow white Jesus. You're the ones following Egyptology, right? You're the one that's following Islam. You don't know your nationality. You don't know who you are, nor do you care. That's why in Lamentations 4 and Jeremiah 8, the Lord said, pray not for these people, and their iniquity has to be accomplished, right? And it will be. So we're going to see who gets the last laugh, right? It says, I'm going to go to the last verse that I'm going to read. Verse 26, I will also laugh at your calamity, Proverbs 1:26. I will also laugh at your calamity. I will mock when your fear cometh, right? I will mock when your fear cometh. So, true. They probably mocked Noah, right? They mocked Yahawasha. Yeah. But there's a price to pay for that. There's only so long that you're going to be able to go and get your 5 minutes of fame. And now these guys are going to have to keep up the hype. Mock means to make fun of, trick, delude, and fool of. To treat with scorn. The scorners delight in their scorners, and fools hate knowledge. We'll see when that time of judgment come. That's all I have on that. Shalom.